观众晚安，欢迎起来 Focus 全球新闻头条。我们要关注的是以色列对加萨南部地区开始攻击，坦克部队打头阵，摧毁了民宅，然后会结合地面部队跟哈马斯开始巷战。以色列指挥官这个时候指出，这个战术是从俄罗斯攻打乌克兰失利的经验当中学习到的。10月7号，那就是整个悲剧爆发的起始，哈马斯屠杀了以色列人，传出当时就集体对绑去的以色列的女性施虐又性侵。以色列举证，但联合国呢却始终没有针对这个举证发言，引发以色列愤怒。在这个星期一，联合国特别召开会议，针对以色列指控哈马斯掳走女性加以性侵暴虐的事情展开调查。
以色列对加萨南部地区进行大规模地面行动，坦克部队负责打头阵，所到之处首先进行炮轰，将民宅全夷为平地，为跟随在后的地面部队排除危险。以色列指挥官表示，这个战术是从俄罗斯攻打乌克兰失利中学习到的。
We saw that where the Russians fought only with tanks alone, they were more vulnerable. This combination of combined power overcomes almost every problem on the battlefield.
坦克部队首要目标就是摧毁民宅，不给哈马斯躲藏的空间。此举也引发国际社会批评。以军回应，他们已经事先撤离民众。
Yeah, that's exactly what we do. We're firing for the buildings. We destroyed, but we make sure that this building is empty from citizens.
We've seen a lot of civilians die in Gaza.
No, this is war.
哈马斯则使用反坦克系统回击，哈马斯还公布了袭击以色列战车的画面，但以军嗤之以鼻，宣称他们的坦克车没有受到重大损害。
Hamas takes them on out of commission.
Zero. Zero. We have tanks that we take to us maybe some, a few days to fix them and they go back to the battlefield. But destroyed? Zero. Zero.
以哈战时停火结束，加萨平民在以军的炮轰下死伤迅速攀升，物资极度缺乏的情况下，社会秩序也濒临崩溃。一间被炸毁的烘焙店，民众闯入抢走面粉和食用油。
When you have civil order breaking down completely because people are becoming desperate, hopeless, hungry.By the moment, this is of course bound to happen.
加萨的人道危机，以色列难辞其咎。但另一方面，以色列也控诉联合国漠视哈马斯对以国女性的暴行。10月7日，哈马斯攻击以色列，集体对女性施虐和性侵，最后杀害他们。这些受害女性的遗体留下了无数证据。以色列的救护人员也指证莉莉。
While we're storming through those houses, The doors I open, it's a bedroom. I see two girls, two teenagers, I guess 13 or 14 years old. One is lying on the floor, one is lying on the bed. One on the floor, she's lying on her stomach. Her pants are pulled down towards her knees. And there's a bullet wound on the backside of her neck.
过去几个星期，以色列警方展开调查，约谈当时的目击证人，搜集哈马斯拍摄的影像，还有法医的鉴定报告，并将这些证据提交给联合国。但屠杀事件至今近两个月，联合国却对哈马斯性侵保持沉默，让以色列十分愤怒。
Neither of them acknowledged or recognized the existence, the fact that sexual violence was part of the Hamas massacre. And by not acknowledging this, by dismissing, by ignoring, they are in fact almost, I would say, legitimizing.
周一，联合国针对性侵事件召开特别会议，犹太女性团体在会中提出大量证据，指控哈马斯是预谋集体性侵，犯下违反人道罪。
This demonstrates a preconceived and premeditated plan, and that is why it does amount to crimes against humanity.
联合国妇女署近日终于发出声明谴责哈马斯，联合国也成立了调查委员会，针对性暴力事件进行调查。哈马斯否认犯案，辩称是其他武装团体所为。
Do we believe the Hamas spokesperson who said that rape is forbidden, therefore it couldn't have possibly happened on October 7th? Or do we believe the women whose bodies tell us how they spent the last minutes of their lives?Who are we going to believe?
联合国表示，所有的调查结果将会送交国际刑事法院进行审判。TVBS 新闻综合报道。